Happy morning, children. Welcome back to the online classes. Today, before getting into the session, I would like to tell you a small story. Hope everyone are ready to listen the story, right? Once upon a time, there lived a very big and tall tree near a river. Now, what is a tree, children? Do you know what it is? Yes, a tree is a very tall and big plant, isn't it? Also, it is a very strong plant. It has many branches in it. The same way, here in this story also, the tree is very big, tall and strong. Also, it has many branches in it and it bears a lot of fruits. The tree, as it is very big and strong, it has more pride, saying that I am the best person in the world. The tree has more pride as it is the very big and strong plant. And on the other side of the river, there were reeds. Reeds, that is also a kind of grass. The reeds are not very strong like the trees. They are very weak and thin. Along with the reeds, there were few other small plants like rose plants, tulsi, mint. Yes, one day the pride tree felt he has to show his power to the very weak plants. So at first, he started to tease the reeds. So, with a very big and gigantic smile, the pride tree pointed at the reed and said, "Hey reed, look at you, how weak you are, so sad. You can't even stand straight. You are always moving on the side where the wind is blowing. You can't even stand straight and you're not even strong. See, look at me, how strong I am. Even the wind blows strong, I could stand straight where you can't stand like me. You are so silly." The reed, with a warm smile, replied, "Dear tree, even though I'm not strong and big like you, I believe that I am beautiful. Moving along the side of the wind is my nature. So I never feel sad or I never felt silly to be in my nature. I love to be myself." One day, there came a huge storm. Storm, do you know what is that? It is the fast blowing of wind. All the reeds, they were moving along with the wind. They bent themselves and they were very flexible. The pride tree was very timid and it was standing straight even in that huge storm. Even at that situation, it started teasing the reeds, saying, "See, look at you reeds, you can't even stand straight. Look at me, even in this huge and big storm, I could stand straight and I am the most strongest person in the world. You can't even stand straight and you can never survive in this strong wind. Look how weak you are." Suddenly, the wind, it started blowing even faster. All the reeds were flexible and they were moving along with the sides of the wind. But the pride tree, which was standing straight and upright, it has fallen all over down on the river. The tree was very much shocked and it was continuously shouting, saying, "Hey, how could I ever fall like this? I'm the most strongest person in the world and how could I fall? And those weak plants, how could they survive in this strong wind?" The moral of the story is be humble all the time, children, and don't ever have more pride in you. Even if you are weak in few things, if you are more confident, humble and kind, you will be the cutest kid always. Okay, children? I think all of you liked this story, right? So now, let us get into today's topic. In this story, I have told you about a tree, reeds and few other small plants. Yes? That's the topic for today, children. We are going to learn about the plants around us. I guess you have learnt about plants in your previous classes. You could have learnt about the types of plants, parts of plants and germination of seeds. Am I right? Today, we are going to learn about the types of plants, children. I hope every one of you are ready to listen. You all like plants, right? Plants are of different size, children. Some are tall, some are short. Some are big and some are small. Some are very strong and some are very weak. As I told you before, the tall, strong and big plants are called trees. I guess you could have seen more number of trees around your house. Even in our school, there are so much of plants and trees, right? Let us see few examples for trees, children. Coconut tree, tamarind tree, mango tree, apple tree, and there are so much of other kinds of trees, right? You could have seen more number of trees around your houses or when you are going to your relative's house or when you are coming to school on your way. You can see different kinds of plants and trees. Now, tell me children, are all these plants and trees are of same size? Are all the plants and trees big? Or is all the plants and trees are very small? No, one plant it may be bigger, one may be small, one may be short. As I told you, plants are of different size and shapes. All the plants will never be the same. Here, the tall, big and strong plants are called trees. I told you, isn't it? The trees are the examples of big plants. Big plants are called trees. T-R-E-E-S, trees. They are very strong and have thick stems. The stem part is known as the trunk. T-R-U-N-K, trunk. The stem part of a tree is known as trunk. And the trunk part is covered with the bark. B-A-R-K, bark. Now, let me ask you a question, children. Tell me which animal lives on trees? Name the animal, children. Which animal lives on trees? I think you have the answer. Yes, monkeys. All the monkeys will be jumping and climbing on the trees, right? Children, I told you the tall, big and strong plants are called trees, isn't it? Now, look at this. Wow, what is this, children? Yes, this is a tree. Look at this, how tall, big and how a tree is growing. Can you see this? Yes, the big and strong plants are called trees. That's right. Now, let us do a small activity, kids. Miss will show you two pictures and I want you to find out which is the tall plant. Okay? Now, look at the pictures. There is a rose plant and a coconut tree. Yes. In this too, which is the big and tall plant? In this too, which is the big and tall plant, kids? Is it the rose plant? No. Answer is the coconut tree. So now, I guess you are clear about the trees. Trees are very big, tall and strong plants. They are very huge and they have thick stems. The stem part of the tree is called as trunk and the trunk part is covered with bark. Now, let us get into the next topic, children. So far, you are clear about the big plants. Am I right? What are big plants called? Trees. Now, let us learn about the small plants. Small plants, they are bushy with strong and woody stems. And some plants, they are with soft stems. For example, rose, coriander, mint, hibiscus are the few examples of small plants. Herbs. H-E-R-B-S. Herbs. Do you have any idea about herbs? Fine. Let me tell you, children. Herbs are the small plants that have very soft stems. Herbs are the small plants that have very soft stems. Some plants, they are very small, children. Also, their stem will be very soft. Those plants are called herbs. H-E-R-B-S, herbs. Some of the examples of herbs are wheat, paddy, grass, cabbage and coriander. These are all the examples of herbs, children. Also, do you know herbs are also used for medicinal purpose? Now, Miss told you grass is the example of herb. Am I right? Now, wow, look at this on the floor. Yes, it is grass. Can you see the grasses? These are the example of herbs, children. Remember, herbs are small plants. Okay? Now, Miss is gonna tell you about the next type of plants, children. The next type is shrubs. S-H-R-U-B-S, shrubs. S-H-R-U-B-S, shrubs. Shrubs are bushy plants, children. Shrubs are bushy plants. They are of medium sized. Medium sized meaning they are not very small. Also, they are not very tall. They are bigger than the herbs and smaller than the trees. Remember, kids, shrubs are bushy plants. Some of the examples of shrubs are rose, jasmine, lemon and tulsi. These are the examples of shrubs. Also, remember, shrubs have so many branches in it. Yes, children, this is the example of shrubs. Look here. There are two rose plants. Remember, rose plant is an example of shrubs. Shrubs are bushy plants. Yes, shrubs are called bushy plants. Rose plant is an example of shrubs. Now, take a look at the picture, children. What is it hanging there? Is it a bitter gourd? Yes, it is. But why is it hanging there? Why is it not growing on trees? Because some plants, they have very weak stems. They cannot grow on their own. So, they need some big trees or walls to get support. Only then they could climb on them and they can grow. Those plants which has weak stems and need support to climb on for growing, they are called climbers. C-L-I-M-B-E-R-S, climbers. Climbers are the plants which need some support to grow. Peppers, grapevine, money plant, pea plant are few examples of climbers. So remember kids, the plants which need support to climb on are called climbers. Yes children, Miss told you, grapevine is the example of climbers, isn't it? Now, look at this. Yes, this is the grapevine. Now look at this, Miss is gonna take grapes from the grapevine. See now, I'm taking a grapes from here. Now, Miss is gonna hold it in my hands. Look, I have grapes in my hand. You should also eat grapes, children. Grapes are the healthy fruits, so eat it regularly. Okay? Some plants are very weak than climbers, like even if a support is given to them, they can never climb on and grow. They could only grow on the ground. Such plants are creepers. C-R-E-E-P-E-R-S, creepers. They always crawl along the ground. Some of the examples are watermelon, muskmelon and pumpkin. Have you all eaten watermelon, children? Many of you eat watermelon, am I right? It is a very sweet fruit. Have you seen watermelon, children? Will it be growing on the trees? No, the watermelon is a kind of creeper. It always grows along the ground. Because they have long, thin and weak stem. Muskmelon and cucumber are the few examples of creepers. Remember kids, creepers are the plants which grow along the ground. Children, Miss told you watermelon is the example for creepers, isn't it? Now, shall we see where the watermelon grows? Look at the ground, children. Do you know what it is? Yes, this is a watermelon. Miss told you, watermelon is the example of creepers, isn't it? Look at these watermelon, children. This is so green and it is very big in size, isn't it? Now, look at me. Miss is gonna lift this watermelon. Shall we try? Yes. See children, Miss has lifted it. This is the watermelon, children. This is the example of creepers. Remember, creepers are the plants that grows along the ground. Now it's riddle time, kids. Be ready to answer. Miss is going to ask you three riddles and let us see who is going to answer it first. Okay? The first question is, I am a big plant. Who am I? I am a big plant. Who am I? The answer is trees. That is right. Trees are the big plants. They are very strong and tall. The second riddle is, I need support to grow. Who am I? I need support to grow. Who am I? Climbers. Climbers are the plants which needs support to grow. If you keep a small stick or the walls, they can climb on it and they can grow. That's nice, children. The third riddle is, I creep along the ground. I creep along the ground. Who am I? I creep along the ground. Yes, the answer is creepers. Creepers are the plants that grow along the ground. Now, Miss is going to show you few pictures, children, and I want you to find out the answers for the questions which I am going to ask now. Ready? Look at the pictures now. There are two pictures given, money plant and the mango tree. Now, tell me children, which is a climber here? Climber, money plant or the mango tree? Yes, money plant is a climber. That's very good. Now, the second question. Which part of the tree is known as trunk? Which part of the tree is known as trunk? The stem part or the branches? Stem or branches? Yes, the stem part. Stem part of the tree is known as trunk. The third one is, which is an example of small plant? Spinach or coconut tree? Which is the example of small plant, children? Spinach or coconut tree? Yes, it is spinach. So that's it for today, children. I hope you have learned a few things about the plants around us. The types of plants, isn't it? What are the types of plants we have seen? Big plants and small plants. Children, iniki enna topics nama paathom? Types of plants. Enna types irukku? Big plants and small plants. Sila plants romba perusa irukum, sila plants romba chinnada irukum. Big plants are called trees. Perusa irukka plants nama enna nu solluvom? Trees. They are very tall, big and strong, isn't it? Trees eppadi irukum? Romba perusa, uyarama, romba strong ah irukum. Then we saw about small plants, right? Small plants eppadi irukum? They have long, thin and weak stems, right? Small plants oda stem eppadi irukum children? Romba long ah, thin ah, weak ah irukum. So big plants na unga parents madri romba periya plants and small plants na ungla madri romba kuttiya irukum. Okay, so what are herbs children? Herbs are the small plants that have soft stems. Herbs na enna children? Herbs na romba chinna plants and adoda stem eppadi irukum romba soft ah irukum. After herbs, what did we see? We saw about shrubs, isn't it? Herbs ka apra nama enna topic paathom? Shrubs. What are shrubs children? Shrubs are bushy plants. Shrubs na enna? Bushy plants. And shrubs eppadi irukum? Herbs vida romba chinnada irukuma illa trees vida romba perusa irukuma? No, shrubs vandu herbs vida konja height ah irukum, trees vida konja short ah irukum. Okay, these are the things about shrubs. And apart from this, we saw two other topics. They are climbers and creepers. Idha thavira nama inno rendu topics paathom. Adu ennadhu? Climbers and creepers. Correct? Climbers na enna? They need some support to grow. Climbers ke enna venum? Either stick illa periya maram edhavadhu irundha adoda support la climbers grow aagum. Creepers, even neenga oru stick vechinganalum, they cannot climb on it. They can only crawl on the ground because they are very weak, than climbers. Creepers kitta neenga oru stick vechinganalum they cannot climb. Yena climbers avida creepers romba weak. So what are the examples of trees, children? Few examples are coconut tree, mango tree, apple tree. Also, what are the example of herbs? They are wheat, paddy, coriander, grass and cabbage. These are the example of herbs. Idu ellam da herbs oda example. What is the example of shrubs we saw? We saw about rose plant, isn't it? Also, along with the rose, what are the other examples Miss told you? It is about jasmine. Shrubs oda example enna children? Rose plant. We saw about rose plant. Am I right? Rose illama vera enna examples Miss sonna? Jasmine, lemon. Idu ellame shrubs oda example. Okay? Apple tree. Some examples of climbers are grapevine, money plant. Yes. And other examples for creepers are watermelon, muskmelon. That's it for today, children. You have seen about the types of plants. We have learnt about trees, the tall and big plants, climbers, plants which need support to grow, creepers, plants which could grow only along the ground. Yes. Now Miss is going to tell you few interesting facts. Are you ready to listen, babies? The first one, do you all know carrot, children? Do you like carrots? Okay, what is the color of the carrot? Carrots, will they be black in color? We have seen them in orange color, right? But do you know carrots are originally purple in color? And do you know cricket, children? In cricket, the batsman, what does he use to hit the ball, children? Is he hitting the ball with his hand? No, he is using a bat. That is right. Do you know from where those bats are made? Cricket bats are made from willow tree. There is a tree named willow. Cricket bats are made from that tree only. Okay, sweethearts, so now today you have learned different kinds of plants. Am I right? Let us end up this session with a very small activity. But Miss is going to tell you the activity and you are going to practice it at home. I believe all of you will try this interesting activity. Now, shall we see what the activity is? You have seen different kinds of leaves, isn't it? Now what I want you to do is take one of your favorite leaves, okay, and dry it under sunlight, either for one day or 2 days. After it is getting dried, take the dry leaf, paint on it and take an impression in your rough note. The colored part, paste it on your rough note and take off the dry leaf. You can see the beautiful pattern on your rough note. Also, you can use the different combination of colors whichever you like. I guess you people will try this activity in your house. There are so many different kinds of leaves, children. They are of different size and shape. By using different kinds of leaves and by using different combination of colors, you can bring out the most beautiful patterns. Try it in your home and enjoy. That's it for today. Take care and stay safe in your house. Thank you.